the truth a little bit, because, well, justification, you're justifying the things that you do. It's okay for you to do them, not for others. But all of this ties in to really the biggest crime is stripping the truth. If the truth isn't there, then there's no value in anything. You can't do anything, without some sort of basis of truth. So all of this kind of goes by the wayside, and you build this society that puts every value, every lifestyle, every belief, every truth claim, everything on the same level, saying that it's all exactly equal. And that sounds, in one sense, or on one hand, that sounds like that's more fair. But it's not. The loser here is truth, and when truth loses, so do you. Everything that you do in life that is productive, that moves you forward, needs that give and take off the backboard of truth. And as the world strives to take this away, this absolute truth away, it's doing you and every other human being a great disservice. When there's no absolutes, it's much easier to not be accountable to something. You don't really have to be accountable to it. Well, because that's your truth. This perception is reality kind of attitude is false on its face, because perception, by definition, is perceiving something. But the thing in which it perceives is the truth, regardless of how you see it. If you perceive that the moon gives its own light, you're wrong, regardless of what you perceive. If you perceive that when you walk, the moon follows you, you're wrong. Perception is not reality. By the very definition of perception, it is the observation, the skewed, often, observation of reality. Reality of that is that which is. That is the truth. But now it's become, well, the perception of reality has more value than reality. Do you see where this can cause the major problem? Truth, the dictionary is defined as conformity to fact or actuality. So perception would be when you perceive fact or actuality. But when you perceive something, it goes through the filter of who you are. It goes through those colored glasses, if you will. And through that, the way you look at things, how you interpret them, it gets filtered into who you are, and you make a decision as to what it means that way. But it means something regardless of how you perceive. Regardless of whether you give a trophy to every child or whether you keep score or not, one of those teams did better than the other. That's the reality. The reality is there are better players than others on those teams. The sad thing is that maybe some of them won't get the hankering to play baseball as a profession or to seek excellence, because it wasn't taught to them to match. And then that permeates the rest of your life, that there's this kind of vying for mediocrity. This desire to live in the status quo where everything is exactly the same. To land safely in the middle. Truth is not the only thing that suffers. Perseverance. Being accountable. Self-reliance. Pushing through tough times. Honing a craft, getting better at something, all these things suffer loneliness. And if you don't look and have a measuring rod around you to see how you do, to see where you can do better, and you never will. And to teach this to the children is horrible. It's a great, huge disturbance. And what the world needs now is not less truth, more opportunity to flail in the mediocrity. But it needs the standard of truth to measure not only your weaknesses, but how much you've grown when you make them strength.
You are listening to the Jesus Project. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1534. This report is sponsored by Indeed.com. If new year calls for more hiring, check out Indeed, the all-in-one hiring platform that makes it easy to attract, screen, and interview candidates all in one place. Sponsor your first job post today after visiting Indeed.com/credit.
Well, isn't simply about numbers. It's more than just the numbers in your portfolio or your bank account. Well, it's all the everyday things that money enables you to do, the goals you're after, things you want to accomplish, and the life you want to live. So how do you get there? Tune in this weekend for Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chapman. Presented by Edelman Financial Engines. Each week, award-winning journalist Soledad O'Brien and personal finance expert Gene Chasky will explore how our financial decisions shape our everyday lives. They'll be joined by Edelman Financial Engines wealth planners and other guests to demystify challenges like tax-efficient investing, retirement planning, and more. They'll share knowledge and tools to manage your finances today and build wealth for tomorrow. Join the conversation. Everyday Wealth airs each weekend and will be available on major podcast platforms. For airtime, visit everydaywealth.com.
Make this the winter of you with Audible. Listen to the best of what you love, from comedy to wellness to the latest bestsellers. Find it all at Audible, with audiobooks, exclusive originals, and popular podcasts. Start listening free when you sign up at audible.com.
Open the door to unlimited possibilities when you enroll at a California Community College. Whether you want to transfer to a four-year university or earn an associate degree, you'll find the support to help make it all happen. Classes can fill up quickly, so enroll today at icangotocollege.com.
Cash call mortgage is a DBA of Impact Mortgage Corp. NMLS ID 128231. Not all applicants will qualify. Equal housing lender. Licensed by California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation. Residential Mortgage Lending Act License Number 4131083. Not licensed in all states, including New York. Call 855-657-9910 for licensing terms and restrictions, or visit cashcallmortgage.com.
Are you being denied a home loan or refi because you're a 1099 employee, self-employed, or a real estate investor? It can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be, thanks to Cash Call Mortgage. At Cash Call Mortgage, we'll take the time to understand you and your income flow. Using 1099 income, rental income, and bank statements, you could qualify for a home mortgage or refi at a lower rate. So if you're being turned down for a home loan or refi because you're self-employed, a 1099 earner, or a real estate investor, instead of hearing denied, you could be hearing approved. To see if you qualify, visit cashcallmortgage.com or call now, 800-933-4062. That's 800-933-4062. 800-933-4062.
Hey, parents. Have you ever wondered how to talk to your kids about the crazy things happening in the world? As great as schools can be, they often don't teach important things like hard work, how to start a business, the golden rule, or how the economy works. But kids need to learn about big ideas like these, which means it's up to you. So, how do you go about it? By telling your kids stories. And that's the power behind the beautifully illustrated Tuttle Twins book. The Tuttle Twins is a series of children's books that have sold over 2 million copies already. These books teach important ideas that teachers and textbooks don't really discuss. And they make it super easy for you to help your kids learn the values that our country was founded upon. If you want to help your kids understand how the world works so they can be a positive part of it, go to TuttleTwinsRadio.com to get your set of books. You'll get a 35% off discount and free activity workbooks too. That's TuttleTwinsRadio.com.
check in for a podcast. Hope you enjoy the traffic cast within the Diamond Bar area. 57 northbound at Diamond Bar Boulevard. Stalled vehicle there has the right lane blocked. New Anaheim Hills, we have a work zone on the 91 eastbound from Imperial Highway to Weir Canyon. Two right lanes coming off until 8 a.m. And look out for a work zone in Hollywood, 101 southbound from Hollywood Boulevard to Santa Monica Boulevard. Three left lanes coming off there. KFI in the sky, let's get you there faster. I'm Jonathan White.
Minutes after they took I from all the spits, but my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption song.
It is the Jesus Christ Show. Yeah, it is. That's an absolute statement. It is the Jesus Christ Show. I am your holy host. Happy to be with you this Sunday, as I am every single Sunday, right here answering your questions and talking about things that truly matter in life and after life. In John chapter 14, verse 6, Thomas is talking to him and says, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, how do we know the way?" In verse 6, my reply is, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." I did not say I am the way, a truth, and the life. This kind of idea that you shouldn't offend, and that I think what happens is you don't want to offend people, so you don't want to make an absolute truth. You don't want to say this is absolutely true. But let me tell you this. Every single statement of truth is exclusionary by its very nature. If you say 1 plus 1 equals 2, that truth statement excludes 1 plus 1 equaling 3 or 4 or 8 or 10. If you say, "Hi, my name is Bob," you've excluded your name from being Karen, or Sally, or David, or Chip. That's the way truth works. It is exclusionary, but that's purposeful and that's good. There's become this attitude that exclusion is bad. If you exclude anything, it's bad. It hurts feelings. It makes people feel bad. It makes them sad. That's okay. Because it's not about excluding people from a private club. It's not about trying to make yourself exclusive in a different way, that you're better than someone, because that is not true. It's about excluding, it's about getting rid of the dross, excluding that which is false, so that everyone learns. People are only excluded from a club like this if they refuse to see where the door is. And the truth of that door being where it is what gets them inside. But it's not like there's a sign outside saying that if you're this race or you're this color or these things that you don't get in. It's that the door is here. And this is how you get in. And in life, there are many of those types of doors that are exclusionary in appearance, but really are there to teach you, to train you, to understand truth. Truth is your friend. Truth is a wonderful partner to go through life. It helps you from justifying things with your partner when you're in an argument. to not just trying to justify and use rhetoric, but to learn, okay, yes, you're right. I'm wrong here. I've made a mistake. To work through those things. But people try and skew this and that everybody's right or the truth doesn't matter and these types of things. And really, you've created a mess. You can't be accountable to you're accountable to the truth, to something that's absolute. And to know even more how absolute truth is, when someone tells you the truth is not absolute, ask them if they're absolutely sure. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your questions, dial 800-520-1534.
I'm Jane Yamamoto, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. A new COVID-19 testing site is opening in Beverly Hills today. The new site on Santa Monica Boulevard is expected to open by 6 o'clock tonight. The site will then be open daily from 6 in the morning to 10 o'clock at night and will be able to perform 2,000 tests per day. Tests offered include a 24-hour PCR test for no charge, a $95 rapid antigen test, and a 30-minute PCR test for $249. The University of Southern California plans to welcome back students tomorrow for in-person learning. USC began the spring semester remotely due to increasing COVID-19 cases in LA County. All SC facility faculty, students, and staff who are eligible will be required to receive COVID booster shots. Everyone on campus will also be required to wear upgraded medical-grade masks instead of cloth masks. Graduate School UCLA also began remote classes earlier this month and is expected to bring students back to in-person instruction January 31st. COVID-19 continues to spread across the nation. ABC's Karen Mitchell says some states are having a problem controlling COVID-19 because of the Omicron variant.
Cases are falling or plateauing in more than half the country, including the Northeast. But the situation is still critical in several states, and many hospitals are still overwhelmed. Among those hardest hit, Wisconsin, which leads the nation in new cases per capita.
And she says some states have asked the federal government for help staffing hospitals and testing sites. Pandemic relief measures are expiring at the same time American families are dealing with inflation. ABC's Deidre Bolton says that means paying more for gas and food.
At the gas station and the supermarket, customers hit with sticker shock. Supply chain issues and near 40-year high inflation sending prices skyrocketing. The cost of meat, poultry, fish, and eggs surging 12.5% compared to last year. The price hikes effectively erasing many of the hard-fought wage increases workers have negotiated during the pandemic.
And a mom is suing a social media company over her daughter's suicide.
A Connecticut mother is filing a wrongful death lawsuit against the company that runs Snapchat. This comes after an 11-year-old child, Selena Rodriguez, took her own life in 2021 because her mother claimed she was addicted to social media. The suit claims her suicide was caused by the defective design, negligence, and unreasonably dangerous features of their products. The statement slams the tech company for knowingly and purposefully designed, manufactured, marketed, and sold social media products that were unreasonably dangerous because they were designed to be addictive to minor users. Mark Ronner, KFI News.
And taking you out to a crash on the 110 in South LA.
It's going to be on the northbound side of the 110 at Adams Boulevard. This one's blocking the left lane. Traffic is backing up to 28th Street. Keep Diamond Bar, look out for a stall on the 57th northbound at Diamond Bar Boulevard. That's blocking the right lane. And we have a crash in the downtown LA area. 101 northbound at Vignes. That's blocking the left lane. Look out for slow traffic as you approach. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Jonathan Weiss.
Southland weather from KFI. A wind advisory in effect until 2 this afternoon. The strongest winds across the eastern Ventura County and northern San Fernando Valley. Plenty of sun today. Breezy this morning. Highs right now in metro LA and inland OC in the low 50s. But it will warm up later with highs in the low 70s. Isolated gusty winds throughout the day in the valleys and inland empire. Highs this morning in the mid-50s, but late this afternoon expect highs to hit the mid-70s. Beaches also breezy this morning, highs in the upper 50s right now. Later though, warming up to the low 70s. We lead local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jane Yamamoto.
Live the glory of the NFL at Super Bowl Experience presented by Lowe's. celebrate the conclusion of the NFL's biggest season ever by getting autographs from your favorite players, photo ops with the Vince Lombardi Trophy, testing your skills in interactive NFL games, and more. Tickets start at just $20, and kids 12 and under attend free every day. Download NFL One Pass to purchase your tickets today. Super Bowl Experience, presented by Lowe's, opens February 5th at the LA Convention Center. NFL One Pass required for entry.
As parents, we've done everything we can to keep our kids safe, happy, and healthy during this pandemic. From finding the best face masks to making sure their hands are clean. And now we have the best tool to help keep them even safer. The most important thing we can do is vaccinate our kids to protect them against COVID-19. Vaccines have been proven safe and effective for children 5 and up. Talk to your child's doctor or visit myturn.ca.gov to find a vaccine near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Better get some more cake from Pink Coffee. You know it's National Chocolate Cake Day next week, and I'm just practicing. And now, the top five reasons to visit Morocco. Number five.
Snowball Toss Friday. You can win $1,500 cash playing your favorite slots with your reward card. 1 to 9 p.m.
Number four.
Genuine. Ride February 4th. Get your tickets today.
Three.
Cozy Gift Giveaway. When you earn 500 points on the reward card, the 24th or 25th.
And the number two,
$500 drawing. You can win $500 cash playing table games with your reward card, Wednesdays and Thursdays, 8 a.m. to 10 p.m.
And the number one reason,
Big Game Blitz. Food, drinks, giveaways, and the big game on Big Screen Inner Ballroom for a small price. Get tickets now.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times!
Before I started Rooter Hero Plumbing, I was an angry young man. Hello, I'm John McClan. I was angry because my dad died when I was 17 and he left me alone. I was angry because I couldn't go to college with my friends and because I had to drop out of high school. It's not a pleasant story. But as I grew older, I also grew up. I realized that my dad didn't leave me alone. He left me with values and principles that continue to shape my life. Dad said be on time. He didn't like it when people were late. He taught me to be polite. It was something I lost, but recaptured along the way. And he taught me to keep my promises, because broken promises lead to broken relationships. We teach and keep these values at Rooter Hero Plumbing. I think we have a pretty good company. I know we have great people. And if one of our heroes fails to live up to these values, please call me. My private number is on the back of every Rooter Hero business card. You can also reach us at rooterhero.com. Thank you.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
24 hour news. More stimulating talk.
Things that truly matter in life, and of course, the afterlife. I encourage you to be bold and brave and go to your phone. We have your theology question or life situation question anywhere in the U.S. today. Dial 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534. Lisa, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Thank you. My question is, should Christians tattoo their bodies?
Well, should they or can they?
Should they, according to scripture, should they?
Should they is going to be an individual choice, because there's nothing in the Bible that says they cannot. There is Leviticus 19 goes through some religious laws that some people get confused about that says, in verse 28, you shall not make any cuts
in your body for the dead, nor make any tattoo marks on yourself. I am the Lord. The verse there is actually talking about practice. As a matter of fact, most of these in Leviticus are talking about a practice that pagans were doing, that our Jewish brothers and sisters didn't want to be associated with and wanted us to look as different as possible from them. And this would fall into the same category. Now, people that have problems with it would have problems with other parts of it too, because just above it, it says, you shall not round off the side growth of your head, nor harm the edges of your beard. So if you shaved, you'd be falling into the same category of tattoos then. Also, the word used for cut would be the same that you'd use for pierce. So any woman that pierces her ears would not have a problem. So any man that shaves, or any woman that pierces her ears, would not have a problem. Not just the tattooing. So really, when it's speaking about tattooing here, it's not. It's speaking about a process that was done to the dead, or for the dead, by pagans, and that it should not be brought to pass by Christians. But having a tattoo for a Christian is not inherently wrong. It depends on the content, of course, but it's not inherently wrong for a Christian to have tattoos.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. How come I got the impression that maybe that's not the answer she was looking for? Sometimes you just pick up on subtlety. Tiny little subtlety. Kind of what I do here. But the Bible is filled with many things, and the best advice I can give you is to see that the entirety of the Bible and understand that there's a difference between prescription and description. These are two very important principles I want you to hear and I want you to understand. The difference between prescriptive language and descriptive language. Descriptive language is Jesus walked up a hill. Now, if I walked up a hill, I walked up a hill. There's nothing really to be done. It's describing something that happened. If it's prescriptive, there's an admonishment. There's a statement of understanding. This is what you should, or this is what you should not do. And with the Christian, it gets even more difficult because now you are looking into what you refer to as the Old Testament, and you're seeing things in there that are based on context of things that were going into the lives of our Jewish brothers and sisters. And they were trying to abolish appearing to look like your average, everyday heathen who did whatever. There most certainly are rules to live by, and Scripture is filled with them. Filled with plenty, or plenty. There's more than 10 commandments, let me assure you. It's not just 10. There are over 400 commandments in Scripture. And to hear those and to respond to them is wonderful. However, don't get lost. Don't get lost in some of the statements, some of the descriptions of things going on, and assume them to be prescribed, telling you you must, because there is a difference. And there's some that have been pulled over through the entirety of Scripture. The context is going to be important in those places as well. That's the key. Jack, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Yeah, hi. I just got a quick question about this thing called lordship salvation and non-lordship salvation, where the lordship salvation guys believe that anyone saving faith and put the willingness to repent from one sin and submit to the lordship of Christ, and then the non-lordship guys say they don't see repentance from sin and the willingness to submit to Jesus and lordship as essential for salvation. And I got into a conversation with a guy, and he said that by me telling someone, or by Christians telling someone to repent from their sins and submit to the lordship of Christ, that's adding work to the gospel. So I wanted to ask you your thoughts were on that.
No, it's not adding works to the gospel. Here's the thing. A lot of people get confused based on what happened versus what had to happen. For instance, people talk about Judas. Should it be put on Judas? Here's this major plan, this big plan. It's going to go down. It's going to put me on the cross. It's going to cover the sins of the world. And everything's going to be taken care of. So why would people look down on Judas? He just helped it along. Well, because Judas, as an individual, specifically decided to jump in and participate in a specific way. And it really felt, you know, kind of whittled down to the fact that he wanted things to be done sooner. So when it comes to things that are going to be done, there's a difference between somebody who is trying to create fire by flapping their wings versus the passing along of a torch. And really, when you're going to spread the gospel or share about any of that, you're just passing the torch. But it's the flame of God always. And it's not something, it's not a work that you yourself can build upon. You can't bring somebody to the salvation of Christ. You can't.
Right.
God does. And God will use you in that process. So when it says that no man should boast, it means there's no bedpost that you can put those notches of how many people you've shared the gospel and you've come to know the gospel through, because they're not yours. They're not yours, so there is no works in that context. Now, the lordship salvation has, you know, some nooks and crannies. In the basic line of things, it comes down to you're receiving God. It's not about you, the things you've done wrong. It's about how good God is. It's not about anything that you've done. It's not even about what the good you've done. It's about who God is. And that's the simplicity of it.
When you talk about repentance, right?
Yes.
A lot of people get confused. I get confused on it, but is repentance more like a change of a heart? It's not really necessarily an act always. So like, we're saved, when we get saved, we're saved from past sins, present sins, and future sins. Is that right?
Yes, of course.
But so the non-lordship guys go, well, it's impossible not to sin, because you're going to sin until you get into heaven. But that doesn't give you a license to sin. So there's like a fine line there, or do you understand what I'm trying to get across?
Of course, they were arguing it in 2 Timothy. I mean, it's not new. The whole point is, are you a good guy? You good guy, Jack? And I don't mean in a biblical sense. I mean, you don't go out murdering and raping and any of those things, right?
No.
Okay, so that's just not who you are. So I come to you tomorrow and I say, hey, I'm doing this thing. We're going to shut down any access to law enforcement tomorrow in your area. There's going to be no video cameras. There's going to be no way for them to find out. And I just wanted you to know. And you found that out. Are you going to go out raping and pillaging because you're not going to get caught?
No.
Because it's not your nature. There's no such thing as a get-out-of-jail-free card. The whole point here is the assumption of the world is, oh, you've got this high life now, and you can do whatever you want, and God's going to love you. God's always loved everyone.
Right.
That's always been the thing. That hasn't changed. Now, the reconciliation is different. The reconciliation, those that get to heaven, is different. So those that have this so-called free, and do whatever they want, just as long as they believe, they wouldn't misuse it by the very definition of what it is. If a kid goes out and gets a new car from his family and every single time crashes it and goes, oh well, not only does that kid not appreciate that car, that kid does not have any feelings for his family.
Right.
And that's different than just a family going, you crashed the car, it's bound to happen, at least you're okay, come on, let's take care of you, and we'll talk about the car. There, it's a matter you've got either allegiance, which is going to be bumpy allegiance because you're human, you're going to sin, versus rebellion, which is you specifically ignoring the gospel, ignoring the word of God, the will of God, and doing whatever you want. And they're two different things, and trust me, they have two different endings. You can't rebel yourself away from the knowledge of God. You can ignore what he has for you to the point of death. There's a lot of ways to reject. But as a Christian, it's not about you. It's about God.
Right.
And not how bad you are, but how good God is. Every other religion, every one of them, Jack, is always focused on man. Oh, man is going to receive Christ's consciousness. Or man is going to receive total consciousness. Or man's going to be so high, he's going to... These are weird wannabe God things. Christianity is the only one that says, nah, man, even good man doesn't do it very well. So God is going to send his son, and his son's going to step in and be the bridge.
So someone could be saved and still struggle with sin, right?
Of course.
Okay.
Of course. The perfection is going to be in heaven when it's washed away finally. But of course you're going to have sin. There's not one preacher, one Bible thumper, one Bible reader. There's not one that isn't struggling. And there isn't one in the Bible either.
These are the same guys that will bring up Matthew 7:1, you know, about not judging. And I go, I told the guy, I said, well, you can judge actions, but you can't really judge the heart. Is that a correct statement?
Well, yeah. You know what? You tell me someone that is upset because you said they look good. Hey, you look really nice tonight. That's a judgment. Not one person goes, don't judge me.
Oh, okay.
They go, thanks.
Right.
Judgment is fine. Judgment, what in Scripture, the judgment that they did not want was that with this newfound understanding of who God was and how it interacted with their life, they didn't want them running around saying, I am better than you. I'm somehow closer to God than you. And that was what was wrong, trying to read men's hearts. That's what was vulgar. That was the problem. Not saying, hey, that whole pipe you have in your mouth, and yeah, the one you're smoking crack with, that's bad. Don't judge me. I will judge you plenty.
You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1534.
This winter, we must all do our part to protect ourselves and loved ones from COVID-19. Getting vaccinated gives you the greatest protection against severe illness and death. And for the first time, everyone in the family ages 5 and up is eligible for the vaccine. If you are already fully vaccinated, get your booster to keep your immunity strong. Keeping each other safer is simple. Get vaccinated. Visit myturns.ca.gov to find a vaccination location near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Small businesses who switch to Spectrum Business can cut their internet and phone bill in half.
Spectrum Business can cut my bill in half? Really?
It's true. You're overpaying and we can prove it. Grab your bill and visit spectrum.com/business calculator. In just 3 easy steps, you'll see your savings.
Wow, I can save over $1,500 a year.
That's real savings.
Visit
spectrum.com/business calculator and hit the switch today.
Yeah,
windows could change the beauty or the efficiency of your home, but boy, do they. My wife Tracy and I called American Vision Windows. They installed gorgeous French doors and kitchen windows that totally changed the flow of our home, brought light and backyard access where there was none. Their work is outstanding. I have friends and family who use them, and now they love American Vision Windows. You've heard Bill and Kathleen's story. Horrible experience replacing their own windows. They started their own company. 20 years later, they continue to beautify homes like mine with personal care and attention. CSLB number 778-326. Trust the window company that my family and friends trust. Order by January 31st. Pay 0% interest and 0 payments until 2023 on approved credit. Some restrictions apply. Call American Vision Windows today. Get that free estimate. 888-226-9908. That's 888-226-9908. Or for all their specials, visit AmericanVisionWindows.com.
If you're with Horizon, AT&T, or T-Mobile, you're paying too much for your wireless service. Because PureTalk gives you the exact same 5G coverage as one of those big carriers on the exact same network, but saves the average family over $800 a year. And PureTalk doesn't lock you into an overpriced, unlimited data contract. Why pay for data you don't need? Instead, get unlimited talk, text, and 6 gigs of data for just $30 a month. And switching is so easy. You can keep your phone and keep your number, or get huge discounts on the latest iPhones and Androids. So what are you waiting for? Start saving today. From your cell phone, dial #250 and say switch now, and you'll save an additional 50% off your first month. That's #250, say switch now. You'll have the option to receive a one-time auto-dial text message from PureTalk. PureTalk is simply smarter wireless.
Cash Call Mortgage is a DBA of Impact Mortgage Corp. NMLS ID 128231. Not all applicants will qualify. Equal housing lender. Licensed by California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation. Residential Mortgage Lending Act License Number 413-1083. Not licensed in all states, including New York. Call 855-657-9910 for licensing terms and restrictions. Or visit cashcallmortgage.com.
Do your plans for 2022 include costly items like home improvements, paying off high-interest credit card debt, or taking a dream vacation? With home values skyrocketing and low interest rates, you could pay for all those things with a cash-out refi with Cash Call Mortgage. Cash Call Mortgage offers low interest rates and great customer service. Check their outstanding reviews by searching Cash Call Mortgage reviews in your search browser. Let Cash Call Mortgage help you achieve your goals this year. Get the money you need from the equity in your home with a cash-out refi. For a free quote to see if you qualify, go to cashcallmortgage.com or call now. Call 800-749-5590. That's 800-749-5590. 800-749-5590.
Checking KFI traffic, we do have a crash in South LA on the 110 northbound at Adams Boulevard. That's blocking the left lane. Traffic is backed up to 28th Street. To Anaheim on the 91 eastbound at State College Boulevard, a crash there along the right shoulder. And look out, Long Beach, stall on the 405 northbound at Cherry. That has the off-ramp blocked. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Jonathan White.
This Sunday, as I'm with you every single Sunday, right here, answering your questions and helping us change the team in the room. And we'll keep answering them. I'd love to hear from you if you have theology questions dealing with God, religion, spirituality, worldview, the Bible. Or if you don't, if you have a position here as well, anywhere in the U.S. there, dial 800.
That's 800-520-1534.
And you can follow us, of course, on Twitter during the week and during the show.
You can't bust this.
Lou, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Yes, I have.
It is a little confusing. Really what it has to do with is that there's many words that are translated as hell, but they do mean different things depending on how they're used.
Busted.
Is Sheol. Sheol simply means the place of the dead or the place of the departed souls or spirits in the New Testament. It's in the New Testament, the equivalent of Sheol is actually human. But it often gets translated hell, so it can be... Hear that and think that that's there. It's Hades. It's the place of the dead. Other scriptures in the New Testament will talk about the same thing and refer to Sheol, a temporary place where souls are kept as they wait for their final resurrection and judgment. I find out more at Revelation 20.
11:15. So it's really one of those things that it's like heaven. If you think of heaven, it often refers to the layers of heaven. And the layers of heaven really are not layers of heaven at all. It's different heaven. So they talk about the first heaven. The first heaven is the sky that you see if you're standing on the earth and you look up.